Click the bell icon to get latest videos from Ikeda.
Hello friends, in last video we have seen something called as different types of inheritance. Now in this video we are going to see how we can use constructors with the inheritance. How we can actually use what type of constructors we can actually use, what combination of a constructor we can use with the inheritance. So let's see the program directly. So basically, whenever we are talking about constructors with inheritance, there are certain rules you need to follow. Okay, the one rule which we have already seen, that if you are having a parameterized constructor and if you are calling it, okay, the main thing is you should have at least empty default constructor in your class. Okay, now same rule is applicable in the inheritance also. So let's check it out, what are the rules you have to follow whenever you are using constructor. So here I am having class A and it is having one variable I. And here I am having one parameterized constructor. So what parameterized constructor is doing, it is taking value of I and then it is assigning value to it, 1, and then it is printing the value that is 1. Then I am having inheritance over here by using extends keyword. So I am having class B which is extending all the features of A. That means I will be having I variable available to me. Then I'm having public class B, public B, that is the default constructor of class B. It is having J value assigned, that is 2. J value, J is my instance variable, and then it is just showing value of J. Here I'm having simple class constructor test where I'm doing job of creation of object of childmost class. So which is my childmost class? It is a B class. So B is equals to new B. Here I'm printing value of B of I, as inheritance is there, that's why I value is available to me as well as J value is available to me. So the first rule which we are going to see. So let's compile this. Basically, this program we won't compile. Why? Let's check it out. So I'm getting constructor A in class A cannot be applied to the given types. Basically, if you see, you will say that I have not created object of A, I have called object of B. So basically, why it is giving error for A, right? So basically, whenever I'm calling in inheritance, whenever I'm calling childmost constructor, it first goes to the parentmost constructor. So parent default constructor is going to be looked first. If it doesn't find, it throws you there. Okay, so even if I'm having constructor in parent, but it is a parameterized constructor, so what you should have over here, it's a childmost. You should have here, it's a default constructor, which is important. So it will go to default constructor, it will execute everything inside it, then it comes back to the childmost constructor and continues the execution of the same. So let's check it out. Now it should work. So let's try to compile it. Now it has compiled. Let's try to run it. So what it is doing, as I told you, it first goes over here. But before continuation of execution of it, first go it it checks for default constructor of class A. That's why what it is showing. See, constructor A I equals to 1. That is my first output. After that, it returns back to here, and then it shows constructor B J is equals to 2. And then at the end, it has came back to main method and showed the value of I and J. Okay, so that is a simple example of how we can actually follow constructor rules while using inheritance. Now one more example we are going to see with a multiple inheritance. Have a look over here. I'm having class C, which is having default constructor, and it is showing constructor C. Then I'm having class A, which is extending C, and it is showing me it is having value instance variable that is I, and it is having default constructor and it is showing the value of I. Then I'm having B extending A. So see, C is extended by A is extended by B, and then it is having instance variable J, and it is having default constructor over here, which is showing value of J. So what will happen now? As you already aware, I will be creating object of childmost class, so that is B class. So when I'm calling constructor over here, first it goes where? Now in this case, it will goes for constructor of A. So it goes in constructor A, but constructor A, class A is also having some parent class. So over here, it goes to constructor of parentmost class. Okay, so I have parentmost class constructor over here. That is, yeah, it is there. So it will show me, if you see, output of it. Let's compile it first. And then run. So over here, if you see, I'm having public C, that is constructor C. Okay. So even though I have called constructor of B, it has gone first to the parentmost class, that is class C. Then it came to B, A, and it is showed constructor A, I is equals to 1. Then it came to B, and then it is showed a constructor B, J is equals to 2. And then it came back to the main method and showed the value B of I and B of J. Okay. So always remember these rules related to the constructor with a inheritance. Okay. So if you like this video, do share it. Okay. Thank you.